Okay, I have a big disclaimer to make, all right? So I just read the comic very recently, and now I'm watching the show. So there are a lot of points in this review where I just say, like, in the comic, there's this, and in the show, there's this. Comic, show. And I know I don't really like doing that because I'm like, you should judge show as a show and comic as a comic. So it's just that it was so fresh in my mind that I kept going back to it. So I'm really sorry about that. If that sounds like annoying at a point, just let me know. I'm sorry. Anyway, here we go. Based on the comic book that came out a while back and ever since then has had some continuations in terms of volumes, The Umbrella Academy is the new superhero show now on Netflix. I've actually been kind of interested in this show ever since I saw a sneak peek of it back in October for New York Comic Con. I've actually done a video about that, you can check it out. It was something that just grabbed my attention, and I thought, you know what? I do actually want to see what this would be about. Here we have the Hargreaves family, which was constructed out of a rich billionaire, a very eccentric one at that. Suddenly finding out that 43 kids were born at the same time, on the same day, practically out of nowhere, from 43 different women who were not even pregnant, and these babies had some special abilities, but he was only able to obtain 7 of them, and they became the inaugural class of the Umbrella Academy. They were falling apart, however, over the years, and many years have passed, but Sir Hargreaves has died, and the kids come back together to figure out what happened to him, while one of the kids who goes back in time and forward comes back to tell them that the apocalypse is in the next 8 days and that someone is going to completely destroy the world unless something is done about it. The original comic is a very wacky, zany piece of literature. There's certain mindset is required to really enjoy it, I think, at points. It's just so insane, and it's also kind of depressing. It works as a very dark comedy at points, but it also works as just a terrible tragedy of characters. The show also does this for the most part. In fact, I will say this, as a show, this is great. As far as superhero outings go, I would say this is one of the best premiere seasons for a superhero show in quite some time now. Very visually brilliant, beautifully acted. They've done a very good job of bringing this to life as best as they can. To their credit, give them a big round of applause, they've come pretty close to pulling off some pretty impossible stuff that's in the comics. One of the things, however, that the show does in comparison to the comic is focus more on the characters. There are certain things that are added in, there are more character moments. There's a lot of development for one character in particular, that being Vanya Hargreaves, played by Ellen Page. She gets a lot more development in this particular story, and I think that also works to its credit at points because if there's any gripe I had with the comic, which is really great by the way, if you've not read it, please go check it out. One of the things I had an issue with was that certain things were just glossed over a bit faster than I wanted them to. I get it, it's a comic, you gotta keep the readers interested. But in the case of a show which is 10 episodes, each an hour long, you can do a lot, and they did do a lot. They took their chance and they added a lot more for certain characters who did not sometimes get all the amounts of attention that they could have gotten. But let's just talk about the rest of the show as well. It's beautifully directed. This is one of the most unique superhero shows out there. It's very stylized, very unconventional stuff. I can't really think of anything like this. And it also constantly makes fun of the superhero genre. There are certain things that characters will say, like, oh, so this happen now because we're doing this, and then it'll be passed off as this joke, like, yeah, that's not how it works. That's not how real life works. At one point in time, a character is pointing at something and saying, so should I just lift my fingers and do it like this? And they're trying to do it, and then they just suddenly start laughing in the middle, like, I'm sorry, this is so stupid. I'm sure others might think it's normal, but this is just so stupid to look at. And that, in my opinion, is what makes this so compelling to watch. It's like a deconstruction of the genre in a way. It actually kind of is. It actually is a deconstruction of it. It takes tropes and it essentially throws them into this blender and says, yeah, we're not doing a lot of these things. We want to make this as bizarre as possible so that it all feels like you're in like a Twilight Zone kind of a superhero world, which can often lead to some issues in terms of viewership because not everyone will be able to give in to that madness, so to speak. But if you really give it a chance, I really think you're gonna enjoy what they've done here. Music is also a very important part because if you read that comic, music plays a big factor in this, and they play that up really, really well. And the soundtrack is great. It has a gorgeous score as well, which I highly recommend listening to, especially the part called Apocalypse. Fantastic track. In fact, the acting is all to be commended. There are some choice actors that they've gotten for this. All the cast members, all of the numbers 1 to 7 that are in this show. The real gem, however, of this entire cast is Aidan Gallagher as number 5. He's a 58-year-old man who has gone back and forth in time, but in coming back to the present, he has reverted to a 58-year-old man in a 17-year-old's body. And so when he is having conversations with everyone, which are more intellectual and are a lot more advanced, sometimes people around him just get so surprised, like, really? You're saying this? I mean, you're just a kid. It's like, no, he's not just a kid. He's had years of experience behind him and he's seen things. And the way he manages to portray that, there are points where you forget that, oh, right, he's trapped in that body. You're actually convinced you're listening to a 58-year-old man mumble, grumble at points at certain things. And it's just really impressive character acting on his part. And this is extended, like I said, to everyone in the cast. Everyone does a brilliant job bringing their characters from the source material to life really well. Let's talk about Ellen Page for a little bit. She plays Vanya, who is actually the main character of this entire show. In the comic book, Vanya goes through a very, very tragic story. How she ends up is, well, a lot of the crux for what the story that they're trying to tell. No spoilers, but things don't quite go very well. And one of my little gripes with the way it is handled in the comics was that I wish there was a little more to it. I know I keep going back to the comics, but I can't help it because I just read the comic, and so it's really fresh in my mind. They've added a lot more to her in this. There's a lot more into why certain things that happen later in the season are because of certain other things that have happened while in the beginning of the season. And it gives you a little more time to really get into her struggle, into her downward facing spiral. That is such an emotional core of the entire show that you gotta address it. There's also one other thing which I did appreciate, which is in the changes that it makes from the material to the show, there is one thing which always bothered me, which was the way things finally wrap up in the comic book. I wasn't always the biggest fan of it. They've changed it a bit in this one, and in my humble opinion, I think it's a lot better than the way the comic handled it. But that's just me. If someone else thinks otherwise, I don't know. I personally think it was handled a lot better. I do have some issues, however, with the show as a whole, and one of them is its tone. Sometimes you can do a lot with literature that sometimes does not quite translate that well to screen. Now, I'm not saying it's bad, but there are a few very abrasive shifts that happen throughout the entire show, between some very dark comedy to just plain comedy to suddenly it's extremely dark and very violent and very disturbing. Now, I understand what they're going for, how unstable their lives are, but sometimes it just feels like a massive shift out of nowhere. Like, there's a character in this who is often cracking jokes, and suddenly it goes from, oh, this guy's a very happy guy, to, oh God, wow, that shifted very quickly. I would say the biggest one is that while it's very stylish and unique in how it's trying to tell its story, it does have a few storytelling aspects to it which are a bit similar to other things, a bit familiar. So it doesn't always remain unpredictable. It does have some predictability to it, particularly with one character who they introduce very early on as somebody who one of the main characters knows. And as the show progresses, you're kind of coming to conclusions that, yeah, this is going to happen, and then this is going to happen, and then this is going to happen. And pretty much those things happen, so you can take that however as you will. It's just one of the more abrasive parts, I would say, of the entire season. And it does kind of bog it down at points. There's also a couple of side characters who I didn't entirely need, but they were there. They added a couple of things interesting to the plot, but not really. It wasn't required for them to be there, you know? That's it. It's a wonderfully shot show as well. It's gorgeous to look at. Some terrific special effects. Netflix is really up their game. Beautiful soundtrack, great performances, great writing, beautiful direction. It's a very interesting show to watch right now. I highly recommend checking it out if you've not yet started it. Read the graphic novel, sorry, comic as well. It's a lot of fun. And let me know what you guys think. I'm gonna give The Umbrella Academy season 1 an A minus. Guys, thank you very much for watching. Look forward to more videos very soon. As always, if you like this, please do subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the movies.